Renewed fighting in northern Gaza is fueling a dispute within Israel's war cabinet. Gary Lane has that story and more from the CBN newsroom. Gary?
Gordon, the IDF is fighting Hamas in areas of Gaza that it cleared out months ago. As the terror group reforms, Israeli Prime Minister Netanyahu is sparring with his defense minister over the future of Gaza. CBN Middle East correspondent Julie Stahl has more.
As the fighting intensifies in central and northern Gaza, a friendly fire incident near the Jabaliya refugee camp left 5 Israeli soldiers dead and 7 more wounded. The renewed fighting as Hamas regroups in areas once cleared by the IDF is fueling internal disagreements over ruling Gaza after the war is over. Israel's defense minister is blaming Netanyahu because he hasn't helped other Gazans take control.
I call on Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu to make a decision and declare that Israel will not rule over civilian affairs in Gaza. There won't be Israeli military rule in Gaza, and an alternative leadership to Hamas in the Gaza Strip will be advanced immediately.
Netanyahu says no Palestinian leaders will step up to govern until Hamas is wiped out.
Until it is clear that Hamas does not control Gaza militarily, no party will be willing to take over the civilian management of Gaza for fear of its safety. Therefore, the talk about the day after, when Hamas remains intact, will remain just talk, empty of content.
The U.S. Secretary of State again demanded Israel come up with a day-after plan. The U.S. is pushing for a two-state solution with the Palestinian Authority in charge. But Netanyahu says the PA is unacceptable because it supports, funds, and educates for terror.
The non-Hamas civilian administration there, with an Israeli military responsibility, overall military responsibility, that's the only thing that would work. And but there's one precondition. You know, the day after Hamas is the day after Hamas. The day after Hamas is destroyed. You can't have it both ways.
Meanwhile, the International Court of Justice begins hearings today on South Africa's request to stop Israel's offensive against Hamas battalions in Rafah. Egypt, the first Arab country to sign a peace treaty with Israel, is now joining that effort. Julie Stahl, CBN News, Jerusalem.